Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm Colin Dice, a guitar instructor as well as a songwriter. Now, if you want to hear some original songs of mine, you can always click into my channel and see the songs that I have put up. Okay, coming to this song, I'm so glad like we're doing this one today. This is Yesterday by the Beatles. I think one of the most iconic songs, and I just love this song. I just thought like I need to show you the song first, because even though it has 9 chords in it, I thought this is going to be a challenge for all you beginners and all of you like who have started playing the guitar, because like this is what you have been aiming to do. Play all these chords, so many chords, quickly, fast changes and all that stuff. And it shows a lot on your guitar playing, because like you can take your guitar playing to another level, right? Okay, so first things first, I'll play the song so that you have an idea about the song. If you don't already, if you know the song, great, but I'll just show you what we are going to be getting into while playing the song and the chord changes. Okay, so watch my left hand over here moving pretty fast. Don't worry about it, like you will be able to play this song pretty quick. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4 and yesterday, all my troubles seems so far away. Now it looks as though that you're to stay. Oh, I believe in yesterday. Suddenly I'm not half the man I used to be. There's a shadow hanging over me. Suddenly, is why she had to go. I don't know, she wouldn't say. I said something wrong. Now I long for yesterday. Right, so if you guys are wondering like how am I going to be playing this song, don't worry about it, I am going to be showing you, okay? Now the chords, oh my god, there's 9 chords, don't worry about it. Like first of all, I have put up videos in my channel a couple of months back, you can check them out. I've shown all of these chords in the guitar song series where I was supposed to be doing Yesterday by the Beatles, which is this song. So don't worry about it. Learn, you can check up on those videos, learn all of the chords. Now I'll just tell you a brief on the chords. You have the F, the A major, the E7, the D minor 4th, okay. Fifth one is going to be C7, 6, okay. Seventh chord is going to be B flat, it's going to be a G on the 8th and the G minor, okay. Now don't get intimidated by all these chords, because like everything is simple as long as you put in the efforts and the hard work, okay? And I'm sure you guys can do it. Otherwise, I wouldn't be showing you this video, okay? Now, onto the song. Right. First things first, we need to practice the chords and the changes, right? So what you have to do is that, remember that the most important thing is the rhythm section, okay? And why? Because this rhythm section has a time, yeah? Everything is played in time, so you got to be keeping count, okay, or time. Now, for changing the chords, you got to be doing this in keeping a count, right? That's what I'm showing you. So somebody else might show you some other way, but the most important thing is that you have to change it on the counts. So what do I mean by the counts? Basically, it's 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. Okay, once you know these counts, you're going to be changing it on the counts that I'm going to be showing you on the screen, okay? Now, for example, if I'm showing you, change it on the 3 for A7, okay? It means 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. So I changed the A7 on the 3, right? If you notice that. Let me show you all the chord changes. So I'm changing F on the 1. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and A is going to go on the 1. 1 and 2 and now A7, 3 and 4, right? So are you understanding what's happening over here? You're changing the chords on the counts. Okay, that's pretty simple, right? All you have to do is change all the chords, know all the chords first, check out my videos earlier, and just change them on the counts that I'm showing you on the screen. That's all you have to do. Now, that's a practice that you have to do over and over and again. Okay, so the more you practice, the better it is. Now, coming on to the practice, we'll do that once, and then we'll go. Now, this is what we are doing for the verse of the song. The next part is going to be for the chorus, okay? So I'm going to continue from the verse. I'll stop a bit and then we'll go for the chorus, okay? Now, the verse chords, here we go with the count. Counting 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 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 1. Now, that's a practice that's really going to help you throughout your guitar learning experiences, okay? So, you guys are learning guitar, okay? For all of you learning the guitar, this is going to really help you keeping count and time, okay? So, practice this as much as possible to get the verse going on for this song. Now, over to the chorus chords. Here we go with A. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. So how simple was that? Okay, you must have thought like, oh my God, how am I going to be doing all these chord changes and it's going to be impossible, right? So what I've shown you is the most simplest way to understanding how to work on the song. Okay, now for anything, there's a process and you're going to be following those steps. So the first step I've shown you was practice the verse with all the chord changes on the counts. And the second, the chorus, change the chords exactly on the counts, and that's setting you up to playing and changing the chords for the verse and choruses, okay? So once you've got that going on, you've done that practice many times, we're going to go on playing the song, okay, and singing it. Right, now the thing about this is that the singing part is that you've got to have it in you to sing it on time, okay, and in tune. So that's very important. Now imagine singing it on a karaoke track or something. Yeah, where you have the track with you and you're just singing it in time and key because you know the song. Once you know the song, you'll be singing it exactly how it's supposed to be sung, right? So you know when to start and you know when to end. So that's what I'm trying to tell you. You know how to start and end. Once you know that and you've got the backing track, which is yourself now, because you're playing the chords, you're playing the rhythm. So you're supposed to know like when you're supposed to be starting, and you got to have that gut feeling inside of you, that intuition, when to start, when to stop the song. So once you know that, we've done with singing the song, right? The practice. So all you have to do is like play and sing the song. Does that make sense? It's so simple, okay? All you have to do is that imagine, tell yourself that I'm the backing track, and you have your track with you, okay, and that is you. All you have to do is sing the song now, okay? Once you know the song, just sing it, right? So again, just to explain to you, learn the song many times and you gotta know like how the feeling inside you. Okay, I'm gonna be starting at this point, the next line at this point, I'm gonna start that point, and you're gonna be knowing how exactly to modulate the voice of the song. Okay, so keeping that in mind, now let's have a practice together, okay, one last time, okay. Hope you guys are ready, and I'm sure you are going to be ready after a couple of days. So like, I would say like, give it 5 or 6 days, practice it regularly every day, at least 2 hours, okay. So fine, here we go for the last time, one, So sorry about it. So I was thinking about something else at that time, but so that's the way it goes. So all you have to do about the song now is like just practice it again and again and again till you get it right. Okay, and tell me like what was your experience through this video, if you could get it right, and how many days it took you to learn this stuff. If you have any issues also in learning the song, comment. Let me know, I could help you out. If you're going somewhere wrong about it, like, you know, give me a call on the comment, of course. And I will be surely respond to you and let you know, like, maybe where you're going wrong and I could correct you as well, okay? So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I think we've come to the end of the session of the first song guitar series number one, Yesterday by the Beatles. I had a nice time making these videos. I'm sure you guys really enjoyed this video. So thank you very much again. See you for the next video coming out soon. This is Colin Dyes and signing out. Bye bye. Peace and love.